This week on Maker Update, a charismatic crawler, an excuse to release the magic smoke, a noodle sword, and an extraterrestrial guitar. Hey, I'm Donald Bell, and welcome back to another Maker Update, our show covering the latest DIY projects and tips. I hope you're doing well. Fall is here, and I'm giving you all permission to call all those unfinished summer projects something else. They can be year-end projects now. Or maybe we just all move on to something new. With that said, let's get started with the project of the week. This week's project comes from one of DigiKey's own, Jorvan Moss, aka Odd-Jayy. He has a real knack for making robots with personality, and this little guy is no exception. He's calling it the Comet Crawler. It's a four-leg, crab-style robot that uses 8 micro hobby servos in an all 3D printed body. Some of the project's design and code are borrowed from this project from BQ Education called Kame, which is a little more compact and based around some pricier servos. Odd-Jayy's take on the design swaps in the more common and affordable hobby servos and goes big on the droid-style personality. He also includes a lot of cute animations for the robot, which for me are a big part of the appeal here. That said, it looks like there's a lot of interesting features you could draw from in the original Kame code, including Wi-Fi remote control, so there's a broad palette of possibilities here. For electronics, Odd-Jayy is going with a compact pairing of an Adafruit feather and servo feather wing. The code he includes is written for Arduino, so it's conceivable that you could use a different board combination. The original Kame code was written for an ESP8266 board, so again, you have plenty of options to play with. I'm really excited to take this one on. Odd-Jayy is encouraging everyone to take this open source design and expand on it. I'd really like to see if I can get the head spinning or add some sound effects. You can find the project documentation using the link down in the description, which includes the 3D files, code, and bill of materials. Now for some news. We've got a new contest up on Hackaday sponsored by DigiKey. This is the Component Abuse Challenge. It sounds violent, but really it's a celebration of something we've all probably done at some point. That moment of desperation when you don't have the right part to finish the project, but you've got a nasty workaround that may just get you over the finish line. Maybe you're using a standard LED as a photo sensor or turning a speaker into a microphone. Any situation where you're either using a component for an off-label feature or pushing a component beyond its intended range. Submit your project by November 11th. You can find a link down in the description for full details. More projects on Adafruit. The Ruiz brothers have a guide on how to make this LED-lit Rumi sword from the movie K-pop Demon Hunters. At this point, I can't think of a more experienced designer of 3D printed cosplay swords, but what always impresses me with a Ruiz brothers build, aside from the thoughtful details that make assembly easy, is how they're always playing with new ideas to achieve different effects. In this case, we're seeing them use 2 pink LED noodles to light up the blade instead of the usual strip of NeoPixel LEDs. The big upside here, as I see it, is that you don't have to design in a way to obscure or diffuse the telltale look of NeoPixels. For a thin blade design like this, that's a real win. The downside is, I don't believe there's an addressable or color-changing version of these, so you're confined to the color you choose, and you're not getting any nifty effects. Still, they're easy to work with, they look great, and there's no code required. Maybe that's the headline here, and I'm burying the lead. This is a microcontroller-free design, great for beginners, and a great add-on for a Halloween costume. Of course, if your costume idea this year is extraterrestrial 80s synthesizer wizard, then maybe this next project is more relevant. Love Hultén's latest musical creation takes elements from his beautiful synth mashups and reimagines them in an outrageous keytar form. If you're new to his work, oftentimes he's commissioned to take an existing off-the-shelf synthesizer or drum machine and completely reinterpret the look and feel of the instrument. In this case, I'm not sure what the original synth was, but it certainly didn't come with this ferrofluid display on the back or a giant sci-fi antenna that acts as a modulation control. It's incredible. Now for some tips and tools. On Printables, a guide and video from Julius, Curt on how to repurpose this inexpensive IKEA sheet metal lamp into a multi-use project enclosure. This is a great example of how to take IKEA's standardization and economies of scale and turn them to your advantage. Add some 3D printed elements and a few screws, and you've got a unique enclosure that you can adapt for all kinds of projects. We've got a new guide from Erin St. Blaine, and it's not what you think. After so many excellent guides on using WLED firmware to animate projects, it's easy to mistake this for another chapter in that series, but it's not. This time around, she's demonstrating how to use xLights software with Adafruit Sparkle Motion. If your project requires a specifically timed sequence of different lighting effects and events, this is the software for you. In this video, Erin is demonstrating how the software can be used to choreograph a wearable LED light show, but the software is perhaps best known for holiday-themed light installations. With Halloween coming up, it could be a great excuse to learn the software and surprise your neighbors with a cool light show. Finally, on Instructables, CobyUnger has a guide on using Jointly. This is a typeface that is deliberately designed for creating CNC cut joinery in wood. For example, check out this cabinet where the words on the side are all made from functional joints. It's a bit of a gimmick, but it's an interesting way to personalize a woodworking project. You can find a free download of the font at the bottom of the Instructables guide. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, there's a great new video out from Zach the Byte Sized Engineer that acts as a beginner's guide on how to use an oscilloscope. But if you don't already have one, this video is also a great buying guide, showing you exactly what features you want to shop for. Check it out. And that does it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, leave a comment. A big thanks as always to DigiKey for making this show possible, and thank you for watching. I'll see you soon.